Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here. Welcome back to Waverly, Kentucky. As you can see here, our rake is all finished up, and we are sitting here with the baler. So this is actually second attempt at this video. So I started recording and started going to dump the mineral feed into our mixer building, and that did not work. There was no way to get the pellets into it. So I just resorted to going here and buying whatever we needed to fill it. So we're just going to do it that way from now on. And I sent back our pellets and our pellet forks. So we're just going to stick to doing it that way from now on. And we're going to start baling up some alfalfa. And I did already set this baler to the 180 bales. So we are good there. It does not look too promising that we are going to get all that many bales off of it. Autosave do its thing. There is bale number one. Got a nice bale texture, that's for sure. So, I guess we'll just make do with it, see what we can get, and get what we can. That's why we got multiple cuttings, right? We definitely need to put in more alfalfa for next year. Most definitely. Granted, we are also making, like I said, the 180 bales, so they are the larger bales to begin with. So, I mean, there is that. We aren't making as many bales, but they are a larger bale. So we do have that to kind of take into consideration of things, but there's still not very many coming out of here. Rake made a absolute mess of things here. Thinking next time around we're gonna just rake this ourselves. This is a disaster. Good grief. And it's also not really helping that the pickup of this baler is not very large. Some of these windrows are a little on the bigger side. But regardless, we will get this all picked up. And we'll get these bales loaded into our mixing shed there. And the other thing too to remember is this isn't really all that big of a feat, so I guess I can't expect too awful much of it. I think what we could do, once again, is we could combine this and 26 together. Put this whole thing into alfalfa. Be able to get a decent amount out of it. Yep. Have a good sized field then. I really like this tractor, though. My great grandpa actually had a 7080 Alice, just like this. Only he didn't have duals on it, and he actually had the red engine one, not the black like this. Kind of neat to use this, knowing that you know, he had one. There we are, we are full. So this makes five. Setup actually looks pretty neat together. A little more old school baler, old school tractor. I'm liking this. This baler was actually done by, I believe it was Tired Iron Modding that put this out on his itch.io page. Kind of a newer release too. Well, new-ish, I guess. Probably in the last month, I believe, that it has come out. More windows. this paler. Doubt that we're going to. We'd have to be at least 50% good. Well, maybe. Yeah, we might just make it. So we'll make one more, and then whatever windrow is left, we will just leave, because I don't want to have this full, or have this sitting here with alfalfa in it, and we need it for straw. I don't know for sure of just how long. Oh boy. Oh boy. That's not good. I don't know if we'll be baling alfalfa before we bale straw or not. So I'd like to get this empty. That's not looking promising. Hopefully there's enough scraps laying around here that we can pick up and get it full. And that's kind of looking slim. Oh no. At 93, can we find another 7% worth? It's not looking promising. So, I guess we'll just call that good for now, and we'll just have to make sure that we get another cutting of alfalfa before before we need straw. So, man, there's only six bales laying there. Not really worth digging that bale stack way again out for it. But I think we're gonna just pull it out anyways. We're gonna use the 74 here. Get those bales picked up, moved over here. And then that way they're over here, make it a little easier to put them in the mixer. Sneak it out without getting the chopper. This thing was not like 180s. Okay, good to know. We might downsize the bales to like 150s maybe. After we get that last 180 made. So yeah, they're glitching together. Let's hope that when we dump these right here, that they are not going to turn into dynamite and blow themselves to smithereens away from us. In beside our baler, and then we'll grab our loader and our fork for our bale spike. go through it. It doesn't take alfalfa. Good, good. Great. Okay. So that means we're gonna have to change this up. Oh. So this obviously was not done correct. For the alfalfa is not done like Tahitian County is, where alfalfa will work. So, because that baler's full of alfalfa, it is going to need to pop out one last alfalfa bale. So we will need to spawn in 7 hay bales. And this needs to get changed to grass. And put it in harvested. Oh, wonderful. Okay. Well, so now we need to spawn in 7 bales. Round 180 grab. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh. Well, at least now we know, and we know do not plant any more alfalfa, only grass, otherwise that's pointless. And then we have to do what we just did and cheat stuff. Said on Tahitian, the alfalfa is basically just like grass, only it looks and reads like alfalfa. It's the only difference. We are at, wow, not even halfway. only 82 out of 261 yards, or 63,000 out of 200,000. So, what we're going to do now, we're going to unhook the loader. We're going to leave grab or the bale spear on it. Unhook. We will be needing it again. Get this backed up to here. Okay. And I think nitrogen. Okay. So let's spray a load of fertilizer on this hayfield quick. Definitely need it. Oh boy. There is not very much of a difference in between it isn't sprayed. Good. Nice. Okay. Oh, and it's cutting in and out. So that's gonna make this even more fun. Oh boy. What have we gotten ourselves into? Oh, goodness. Well, at least it'll be done and over with. And then we can clean the tractor and the sprayer up, get them put away once, and then either a second cutting will come next, or harvest, one of the two. Which it'll be, I'm not sure. So we did not need that much fertilizer. We could have done with like 5%. But now we know. So, let's get this done away. Okay. Well, then this tractor can take a little bit of a rest. This tractor has been putting in a lot of work between rolling and spraying. Should we get an orc out? It's a good little tractor, though, for these jobs. Until we upgrade to a larger roller, that is. Back this in the shed. The tractor can go back in its shed and take a break. And then we can actually get these closed up. Now, I think... Yes, it does. Oh. It's only right there, though. Okay. So, that's good to know that if... Well, more so when our machines need to be... Need to have service done on them. We just gotta bring them in this bay right here. And then we can get them taken care of. So, since we're not quite to our half hour, let's take a quick gander around our fields. So, we've got 4.36 acres. We're on growth stage 2 out of 6. Expected yield 94%. Yield potential 100. pH is okay. Nitrogen's perfect. That's what I like to see. Expected yield 115%. Goodness. Okay. We are on growth stage 3 of 4, 8.49 acres. Wow. Expected yield, even with pH showing bad. We're at 95 to 99% over here. Our soybeans, we're at 95 as well. pH is actually good for these. A little closer look at the ground texture, kind of like that. 2 out of 6. How about this field here? 115%. Goodness. How about this old field here? 95. Not bad, not bad. 95 to 99. So, let's take a peek here at when are oats ready to harvest? July. Okay, so we still got 2 months to go. So, I think I'm going to see here off camera. I'm going to fast forward a month and see what our grass field does. And go from there. If it's not ready, then I'll fast forward to July, and then we'll be ready to take care of oat harvest. So, I think that's going to do it for today, folks. Thank y'all for watching. If you enjoyed it, hit that thumbs up button, and we'll catch y'all tomorrow.